If you didn't already know, diesel engines have close to no engine braking whatsoever, and that's because they fundamentally work different than a gasoline engine. On a gas engine, you have a throttle body to control the amount of airflow coming into the engine. But with a diesel, there is no throttle body. Power output is controlled by the fueling, so air can just simply flow right into the engine. Things like a diesel particulate filter or a turbocharger can add engine braking, but for the most part, diesels really don't have much of any. And in the context of a small diesel car, that's not a problem because you have your normal brakes that can slow you down. Sure, engine braking would be nice, but it's not the end of the world. But in the context of a commercial truck, semi-truck, a tractor, whatever you want to call it, if one of those trucks is going downhill and it's hauling, you know, upwards of 80,000 pounds, having no engine braking can be a big issue because you need to maintain a safe speed going down that hill, and you can't just run your brakes the whole time because they'll just overheat and disintegrate. That is where a Jake brake comes into play, and it's something that you'll find on a lot of large commercial engines, and it's something that allows those big trucks to have some sort of engine braking. So sit back and get comfy, because today I'm going to tell you exactly how a Jake brake works and why it's used. A Jacobs brake, or Jake brake, compression release brake, compression brake, whatever you want to call it, it functionally is actually very simple in how it works, and it basically just uses the engine's compression against itself to slow the engine down and ultimately slow the vehicle down. Now, the explanation might be simple, but actually visualizing this and fully understanding it is a little bit more complex. So let's get into it. Now, before we can explain how a Jake brake works, we need to first look at how an internal combustion engine works in the first place. And all four-stroke internal combustion engines work in four stages. First is the intake, where the piston is pulled down by the rotation of the crankshaft, the intake valve opens, and this creates a vacuum in the cylinder, which is then filled with air. In the case of a turbocharged engine, it's not much of a vacuum that really pulls the air in, as much as it is the turbocharger forcing air into the cylinder. Second is the compression stage, where the piston is pushed up and the intake valve is closed. This compresses the air inside the cylinder. Third is combustion, where the air-fuel mixture is combusted, and then that explosion pushes the piston back down. In the case of a diesel engine, the fuel combusts from air pressure and heat, but in the case of a gasoline engine, a spark plug is used to start the combustion process. Last is the exhaust stage, where the combustion has done its job and it needs to be expelled from the engine in order to restart the process. With that in mind, you might be wondering why simply just shutting off the fuel wouldn't work as an engine brake. And in the case of a gas engine, closing the throttle body creates a pumping loss, and when combined with the natural drag of the engine operating, provides engine braking. But for a diesel engine, like I mentioned before, there is no throttle body, so your only option would be to shut off fueling. But unfortunately for a diesel engine, shutting off the fueling wouldn't create any engine braking at all. Because there's no pumping loss, because the air is still able to flow in and out of the engine freely because of that lack of a throttle body. Sure, something like an exhaust brake can create exhaust back pressure to then create engine braking, but in its normal state, shutting off fueling won't create engine braking in a diesel. So what's the solution then? And that's where the Jake brake comes in. The Jake brake fundamentally changes how the four-stroke engine operates on deceleration in order to create engine braking. And it does this by making your engine itself, which is simply a big air pump, work against itself. The big change comes between the compression and combustion stages of the engine's operation. During compression, the air that's being compressed is pushing back down on the piston because it doesn't want to be compressed. Ordinarily, this doesn't really matter because the combustion stage creates more than enough force to overcome this resistance during the compression stage. But what if instead of combusting the air, we fully harness the resistance of the compression cycle and then let it out of the engine before that air spring has a chance to actually push the piston downwards? To do this, the Jake brake simply alters the operation of the engine and opens the exhaust valves near top dead center during the compression stage of the engine. This means that all that compression force that is pushing back down on the piston, ultimately slowing down the engine, and then that air is released before the piston begins its downward cycle. Of course, the downside of this is that it's only going to provide deceleration to the drive wheels, because as the engine is being forced to slow down and the drivetrain is fully engaged, it'll force the drive wheels to also slow down. Depending on the context, this can be an issue, such as driving in the snow, where you probably want braking force across all axles rather than just the drive axles. The massive upside to this is safer vehicle operation and decreased operational costs. At the end of the day, anything that can help keep a commercial truck at safe speeds on a downhill is a massive bonus. Plus, with using your actual brakes less, you ultimately have to replace them less often. so it saves commercial truck drivers a ton of money in the long run. On the negative side, using a jake brake is generally not legal intra-city because of the massive amount of noise it makes. On newer trucks, it's certainly quieter, but on older trucks, it can be pretty insanely loud. For example, this Peterbilt 379 has a cat motor, and the jake brake is crazy loud and definitely not something you would want to hear inside of your town. Of course, the legalities of using a jake brake in city is different everywhere you go, but most towns and cities don't allow it. Before we end this video, I would like to note that a compression release brake is not the same as an exhaust brake. I've seen the term jake brake and exhaust brake used interchangeably, but they are completely different. With an exhaust brake, you're adding back pressure to the engine to help slow down its rotation. And this is either done with an exhaust flap or internally on a variable geometry turbocharger. But it's functionally very different from a jake brake, which is using the engine's compression against itself. So that's the simple explanation of how a jake brake works. And you might be wondering why you don't find this on other diesel engines, such as like a Volkswagen car, and that's because there's really no need. In those types of applications, you really don't need the extra engine braking when you have just your standard brakes, because a little car is not towing, you know, 50, 60, 70, 80,000 pounds and needs that extra braking force. But in the context of a commercial truck, it's really just an added safety benefit. It's something that really all trucks should have, and most trucks do have. If you guys like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up because it helps me out. Drop a comment down below if you think there's anything I forgot or anything you want to add, or if you have any questions, I'll do my best to explain. Be sure to check out some of the other videos on the channel, and I'll see you guys in the next one.